What's happening, Tubes? It's been a minute. It's been a long minute. Currently riding, going to Goldsboro to return this truck and another vehicle to a dealership of our chain or whatever. There's many reasons why I have not uploaded a video recently. One of those reasons being because of the weather. From the last time the video, my last video went up, it was extremely cold outside, and you know, there wasn't really a whole lot to do because it was obviously the end of the season as far as, you know, fall going into winter. Well, you know what I mean. Spring came around, and of course, you know, had a bunch of cleanup stuff to do to try to get things organized and set up and pressure wash the house. And been doing lawn work and lawnscaping and all kinds of stuff that just inhibited me from being able to record anything sufficient. Also, that's been thrown in that bag, and I don't think I mentioned it in the last video, but it's been a while. My dog recently, since the end of last year, has had a total of about, I want to say, 8 seizures. His most recent one was just yesterday. Today's Tuesday, the 13th, I believe. Yesterday was the 12th. It's unknown reason, supposedly it's an unknown reason as to why he's having them. And the vet doesn't seem to know, so they automatically assume, they like to call, it's what they want to call idiopathic epilepsy. And supposedly there's an unknown cause as to why it starts, what causes it, or anything. However, it seems to be that, without going into too many details, is that it is involving his stomach, and I'm not sure because I don't really know. I don't know if dogs have blood pressure problems. I know humans do, but I don't know about dogs. I have no idea. You may be looking at, you know, your screen right now and trying to figure out why it's fuzzy on the left side here. And it's because I got that stupid encased phone case on my phone. And for some reason, it's always gave like a fuzzy side to the screen. Let's see, what else has inhibited me from doing a whole lot of recording? I was going to try to actually do a recording a few nights ago and hadn't even been in the building. I mean, out in the shop or whatever. I hadn't even been in it. And no longer than, and it was dark outside, no longer than I was in there, it was like all of maybe 2 minutes. The whole building was just flooded with bugs flying everywhere. So there is plans in the making of me getting a big bug zapper, and I'm gonna, you know, you get bug zappers in various sizes depending on how big your property is, and obviously the bigger the property, the more you would need. Well, I'm not a fan of bugs. You know, I don't mind bugs flying around and stuff, but you know, they kind of get all in the way, they aggravate you, they land on you, etc., etc., etc. And, you know, it can be quite difficult trying to establish a decent video and not be able to because of the nuisance. Anyway, there's a lot of stuff that I've been wanting to record and do and get done, but I just have not had the time, and or if it was something simple. It was already done and over with before the phone could even be whipped out and recorded. Now, as far as the channel is concerned, the channel, how can I put it this way? When I first created my YouTube channel, it was initially going to be just to upload car related stuff, as far as like going to car shows and stuff like that. I mean, you know, any and all, anything that has to do with automotive. And I've gotten more success with it from doing like how-to things, not so much as the automotive side of stuff, but my lawnmower, for example. I did not expect it to get as many views as it's gotten, as far as the like the ball joint change on it or whatever. I recently bought a bumper for it that has no longer been made. I mean, it's discontinued. It was made, I think it was last produced in like 2004, 2005, somewhere in there. And I called my parts guy, who I get all my stuff from, who usually does have it if nobody else does. And he says, man, he says, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but that part's no longer available. And, you know, my only option was to outsource through either eBay or Amazon or whatever. And I actually ended up going up on Facebook and searching like Cub Cadet groups, and found a group that I got into, and guy sold it to me. Wasn't too bad. The cost of it itself was like $45. Brand new is $100, and shipping was like $20, because I mean, it was a weight related. Obviously, the more it weighs, the more it costs to ship. And that was from him shipping it from Indiana, I believe. But anyways, yeah, we're about to be approaching the 8-minute mark on this video. I just wanted to give you guys some insight on what's going on. And, one other thing, too, before I cut you guys loose. Let me take a sip of water real quick. My computer crashed. My laptop that I was either using Sony Vegas and Photoshop and all that stuff on, it crashed. And it crashed due to a corrupted file that was downloaded for a program that I was going to attempt to use, and it completely erased part of the Windows program. And when it did, the computer would not, it would boot up, but you could not see the screen. And it ain't because the screen didn't work, it's just that part of that file was missing. It was part of the you know how, If you know how Windows is laid out, and the outer frame of the boxes that you open and the backgrounds and stuff like that, as far as when you go to files and you look and you know you see all your files in that box that pops up, well, that box and everything with it was gone. Files and stuff are still there. It's just that the shell is what they call it. Shell 32, I believe is what it's called. Was gone. History. No more. So, I ended up having to do what they call a clean install. At least I think that's what they call it anyway. You basically take your like a memory card, your memory stick, and you download the file from another computer that's running Windows 10. And or 7 or whatever, and you then proceed to put the memory card, stick, whatever you want to call it, into your computer and boot it from it, and then it'll load everything it needs to load, and then basically make a copied file of that to the hard drive. That way you have something to boot from. Let me hold this so when I take off it won't move around. Anyways, yeah, I just wanted to enlighten you guys on everything that's going on, and with the computer crashing and the weather and this, that, the other, and just general life. I have not had the time to upload anything, and I felt bad because some of you, I'm going to say some, because some people subscribe for certain reasons, and some people subscribe for other reasons. And usually the other reasons are the ones who are curious to know what's going on and why. So those that came for their certain reasons are usually there for the car stuff or the videos, like the music videos or download music or whatever. But I've quit doing all that stuff. That will no longer be a thing, and that's the reason why I decided to change the channel up a little bit and change the name from what it was to what it is now. And obviously with it losing all of my software when the computer crashed, and me having to do a clean restart or a clean upload as far as like a Windows software, the OS, and knocked out everything that I had as far as my intros, Sony Vegas, Photoshop, everything. And I have not had the time to sit down and really dig down back into it to try to download those programs again to get things going. But I think I'm going to at least attempt to try to do that, either not today, but perhaps this weekend. But anyways, you guys stay cool, and just hang on, and we'll be back shortly, as soon as possible.